Question number three, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. This question is to the Minister of Health. What rules or principles govern the tendering process of multi-million dollar contracts by district health boards? And does he believe these were followed by the Hawkes Bay District Health Board in relation to its community services proposal?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, district health boards are required to adhere to guidance provided by the Office of the Auditor General, the Treasury, the Ministry of Health's operating policy framework, and district health boards' own board procurement and provider selection protocols and policies. From the information currently available to me, I do not believe that these processes were followed at all times by the Hawke's Bay District Health Board. In his recent report, the Auditor General concluded that the Hawke's Bay DHB's policy do not comply with good public sector practice. The Director General of Health has commissioned an independent review of governance practices of Hawke's Bay, and I look forward to receiving that report on the 17th of March.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Can the Minister explain why at the same time Annette King was telling the Cabinet Mr Houseman should be appointed to the board and he understood how to manage his conflicts of interest, Mr Houseman was colluding with the Chief Executive to make changes to tender documents to benefit his own company over all others, and surely even this Minister must see that for the Labour cronyism it is?
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, I note that at all times the former Minister followed the appropriate Cabinet processes for the appointment of that Director, and I suggest the Member wait until he sees the final report from the Director General before committing his own reputation in defence of certain parties.
Supplementary question, Leslie Soper.
To the Minister. Is the Minister satisfied that all required tendering and procurement processes were followed in relation to the contract with Royston Hospital for elective surgery?
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, no. While I do not have access to the material that may be the subject of the Director General's review, I am aware of allegations of inappropriate governance processes that cause me great concern. Some of those allegations were contained in submissions made to me last week that have now been made public. I repeat, some of them.
Supplementary question, Barbara Stewart.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Will the inquiry into alleged conflicts of interest at the Hawke's Bay District Health Board reveal the extent of management mishandling of the contract tendering process as distinct from board dysfunction, and if not, why not?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, as I have not seen a draft or a copy of work in progress of that governance report, I, like the member, will wait for the final on the 17th of March.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Is the Minister aware of the email which shows that Chief Executive Chris Clark instructed staff to send draft tender documents to Mr Houseman, who had indicated he would be a bidder, some weeks before the tender process opened and before any other bidder saw the documents? And is this acceptable behaviour?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe. Order.
Madam Speaker, as I've already confirmed, I do not have access to the material that may be subject of the Director-General's independent review, but I do note that the member seems to be labouring under some misapprehension that it is my role to defend Mr Houseman, which it is not.
Supplementary question. The Honourable Tony Ryall.
Is he aware of this email which shows that Mr Houseman, appointed by the Labor Government, which shows that Mr Houseman, having received this confidential draft tender document, proposed changes that would benefit his company? And is that what he would expect of someone being appointed to the board of that very DHB?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, in the first place, may I reconfirm to the member and to the House that my decision of recent weeks did not turn on which parties may or may not have acted correctly, but is predicated on the level of overall conflict and dysfunction at that DHB. Madam Speaker, in the second instance, I wonder whether the member is drawing upon material which is covered by a confidentiality deed subject to lawyers' undertakings in respect of the Director-General's independent process.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Is he aware from this email that the Chief Executive agreed to alter the tender documents in precisely the terms proposed by Mr. Houseman at a time when no other bidder had such access, and is that a proper and ethical process?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, I think the public will find it very interesting when the final Director General's report comes out, just exactly what has been doctored by whom.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Is he aware of the final document which went out to all tenderers, incorporated the changes proposed by Mr. Houseman, whose company was the eventual successful party, and does he think that all potential bidders were fairly treated equally in this process?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, may I firstly confirm that I do not have access to the material that's in the Director General's draft report, and secondly, may I reconfirm to the House that
Order.
My decisions in respect of the Hawke's Bay District Health Board do not turn on the proprieties or otherwise of any one individual, but rather on the overall level of conflict and dysfunction surrounding that board.
Point of order, the Honourable Bill English.
Madam Speaker, there is a standard in this House that when a minister gives an answer, it should be truthful. Now, in successive answers, the minister has just contradicted himself. In this answer, he said he had no access to the draft material in the report being done by the Director General of Health. In the previous answer, he intimated that material was going to come out showing that someone had altered the minutes of no doubt some significant meeting. Now, he can't say both things to the House within 3 minutes. One, that he doesn't know about the material, and then, on the other hand, give details and quote from that material.
Speaking to the point of order, the Honourable Dr. Michael
Speaker,
Cullen.
The Minister clearly said he'd not received details. In his previous answer, he said that he would welcome the report appearing, and he would anticipate that the report will show exactly who doctored what. I note the highly sensitive reaction from the front bench of the opposition on that matter.
Order. Speaking further to the point of order, the
Madam
Honourable
Speaker,
Bill English.
Dr. Cullen's explanation is completely irrelevant. The fact is the Minister made two directly contradictory statements about his access to the material. The House has the right to know which one it should believe, because it can't believe both.
The Honourable Dr. Michael Cullen.
Madam Speaker, Mr. English himself tried to cover his own butt by saying the Minister intimated certain things. What in fact happened was that the front bench of the opposition inferred certain things, which might imply certain knowledge on their behalf.
Yes, well, this is a matter of debate, not a point of order, and there will be opportunities undoubtedly to do that. Supplementary question, the Honourable Tony Ryall.
Doesn't the Minister recognise that the email from Houseman proposing changes to the tender document to his advantage is a smoking gun showing that there is something rotten and improper in the relationship between the management of this District Health Board and Mr. Houseman, and does he condone this sort of activity within a public organisation?
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, when the Director General's review is finally published, having been delayed by the Board acting at the request of the Chairman, I think we will see which smoking guns are pointed at whom.
Supplementary question. Order. Supplementary question. The Honourable Tony Ryall.
Does he realise that this stench of cronyism all began because of Annette King's foolish and senseless promotion of Mr. Houseman? And has the Minister got any idea why Annette King was so keen to appoint this man?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable David Cunliffe.
Madam Speaker, any appointments that may have been made before my time as Minister are of little concern to me in this instance. I have acted.
Order. Order. Please
Madam
continue.
Speaker, I have set out the grounds of my decision in respect of the Hawke's Bay District Health Board upon taking careful advice and considering all possible options. Those grounds have nothing in particular to do with the appointment to which the member refers.
Supplementary question, points of order. Then we'll move point of order. The Honourable Tony Ryall.
I seek leave to table the emails and documents mentioned in my question.
Leave is sought to table those documents. Is there any objection? There is no objection.